Numero uno. When it comes to the flossing, I boss up. When it comes to your bitch, she's a tosser. Yeah.
Rims so big
that they talk for a pimp. I ain't even got a sphere. And the paint so juicy, just like the words on the booty. Her name Tootie. And now she ride with a pimp, high side with a pimp, getting money for a pimp steer. You see the girl game boosty, give it to her raw and uncut. Pimpy doing some what? You see the girl game goofy, do anything strange for a little bit of change. With the windows break. Just when I'm riding on by, making mama mad, nigga, when I'm sliding on by. So deep in the coop that the girls can't breathe, so they hanging out the roof. Off 180 proof. Just watch me and see just what a nigga do. You know I make the car swing. Oakland, California make the girls all scream. I make their panties all wet. Video playing on the screen on the deck. I'm headed straight to the track. Drop them all off, they can find their way back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 1-2-1-2. What it do, y'all? It's your boy King Eric, the ruler, and the Guillotine team. We at Off the Cuff Radio. I got my homegirl, Mr. Chill, in the building.
Hey there. How y'all doing tonight?
That's right. We get live on Friday night. It's chilly out on the East Coast. And we got a legendary guest on board here. And these are not alternative facts here, my nigga. We have the legendary Dru Down in the building. Are you there, bro?
No, sir. What's happening, man?
First of all, before we start this off, I got to put some respect to your name, man. I got to give you a round of applause.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it, man.
Stepping on the ground, brother.
Yes, sir.
Right, man. It took a minute to get you on, but it's a pleasure for you to come in and chop it up with us. I know you're a busy cat. How you doing out there, man?
Oh, man, you know I'm hanging like wallpaper. You feel me? Sticking like glue. What's happening with it?
you know what it is, man. We needed some of that Bay Area flavor over here, man. You need to drench these cats, man.
Man, automatically, man. You feel me? You know, this game ain't to be told, man. It's to be sold, man. You know? For sure.
So this the show right here. You're going to be, we're going to be blessed here. So,
yes.
Anyways, man, we want to know what you've been up to, man. Like, any future projects you got in the works?
Oh yeah, man. I'm dropping this new album called GP No PC. You know, Lock Up, man. That's the new album coming out. Plus, you know, y'all just heard the two new singles that I dropped off the album GP No PC and the Ghetto and My 501s on Pimp On Records. You know what I'm talking about? That's the label, Pimp On Records, man. You know what I'm talking about? And I got the second album coming out, man, called Welcome to Dru's World. So y'all get ready for that, man. First, y'all got to get ready for the first one.
Okay, Pimpin.
Hello?
Yeah, you there.
Yes, sir.
Hey, chill. You might call. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, your phone was getting a little jacked. You know that East Coast weather be sometimes. It be kind of throwing off the reception. But we in.
Right.
You just hating on the eighth time. I see you. You just hating on the eighth time. That's all. Eighth time.
But yeah, but with this project, man, you have, like, what guests you got on there?
I mean, you know, I got Tech N9ne, man. You feel me? Snoop, Too Short. You feel me? Yup. Most of the Ray Gene on there, you feel me? Ray Gene Life, Lee Majors, Rameen, you know, the Bam Bam. We all in the family, man, you know. It's West Coast love.
And I see you still sticking around on the same people. Well, when I was growing up, I heard, you know, the same people on your album, and I see you guys still sticking yourself. So how is it for you in the industry to still be able to mess with the same people? And, you know, all this beef shit going around all the damn time. And I'm just saying, you know, it's good to see that people can still stick around and make their music and do their business all the time. So how easy or hard has it been for you to be able to do that?
Oh, yeah, man, it's real easy because, you know, I keep it real in the fields. Most of the cats that can't do that, man, you feel me, ain't real in the fields or they ain't turned the leaf or something. You know what I'm talking about? I'm going to stay 100. That's what I am. So, you feel me? I'm going to be able to keep it real in the fields, and that's why I get the love that I get. You feel me?
I mean, it's
got to do with pimping and mac and rapping. You feel me? But, yeah. But, you know, all over the board, my interior is real, 100. You know, I bleed from the heart.
That's what's up. And I hear you got a whole bunch of pimps and macs on your music.
Oh man, you know, it ain't just all about us pimps, man. You feel me? It's G before P, so it's gangster pimping, man. You know, real talk.
Hey,
all of us don't fuck with each other.
That's
all.
You feel me?
Go ahead.
No, go ahead. What you were saying?
I saw that MSNBC documentary on you in the lockup in 2013. Even the guard had to give you props. He was like, you know, a lot of times we have to separate the the source from the actual general population, but he was like, see, Dru Down gonna always get love, and he's respected by everybody in the tank, so we don't even have to do that. So I see even the boys recognize your 100 dick.
Oh, yeah, man, it's much more, you feel me, to motherfucking meet the eye, man. You feel me? Inside and on the outside of these walls, man, you know? It's more than meets the eye, man, you know? Can't talk too much on it, but it is, man. It's 1 mile.
I was going to ask you, too, was... Cause I saw this the other day. I saw this on this joint the other day. Like, how was it like, you know, shooting original gangsters? I feel you should have get an Oscar for that, my man. That's one of the best things I've ever seen.
Yeah. Well, you know, that was a blessing. That's all that was. That was a blessing, man. You feel me? From my manager, man. I had to give it up to him, AJ Crow. You feel me? He brought that to the table. You feel me? And, you know, shouts out to my boy Fred Williams. You know, Richard Roundtree. Rest in peace, Ron O'Neill, you know, Jim Brown, you know, and of course, Pam Grier, you know what I'm talking about? It's them all legends, man, this black history of movies, man, you know what I'm talking about? So I'm blessed to be a youngster that been put in that situation to bless them back, you feel me?
Hey, you know what's wild to me was I put that character up there with my Pac with Bishop and Old Dog. And with Menace, it was like you were disrespecting them old niggas, but you made it sound, you made it dope though. It made me feel bad and laughing about it.
On what? You said on what?
Yeah, you made me feel kind of bad laughing at that role, but you did it so good disrespecting them old heads like that in the movie.
Yeah, you feel me? Yeah, I a lot of people didn't like it, but you feel me? That's a part of acting.
Nah, they better not say nothing. That was some good acting,
yeah,
right
nah,
there.
Nah, hell no, they better not say nothing. You feel me? That's just like, you feel me? That's just like when Pam Grier whooped my ass. Yeah, I ain't gonna let no bitch whoop my ass. Hell out. Yeah, that's just straight. You feel me? That's just a motherfucking movie. Yeah.
Only in the movies, not in real life.
Now, hold on one second. We got our other cat. We got our other comrade, Mr. Sandman. He gonna join us. We got my man from the Bronx.
1-2.
We got
Dru
Down in the building. We got Dru Down in the building.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
What's going on, everybody out there? Got Dru Down in the building?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. What's going on, my dude?
All right, what's up with the Sandman?
I'm good, man. I'm good. I'm definitely, you know, we are definitely thankful that you took time out to come chop it up with us tonight. You know, that's definitely love.
Well, I appreciate it, man. You know, it is what it is, and I do what I do.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Being humble like that, I definitely appreciate
it. Yes, sir, man. And I know y'all broadcasting, right?
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. So then, yeah, y'all let them know, man, I'm trying to come out that way, man, real soon and put it on for the town, man. You know?
Show love to the East. We at Bridgette.
Gotta
cat.
Show love in the East. I'm in the East right now. So I gotta show love.
You gotta come down south and show love to us, too. Don't forget about us today, goddamn.
Oh, hey, I'm on my way. You ain't gotta say nothing, man. I'm on my way. You feel me? I gotta make my rounds, baby.
All right.
Is it like it's so crazy talking to you and shit because like I remember your music from like as a youngin, like back to when you know what I'm saying, motherfuckers had the box. I don't know if you remember the box, like when you called in and they take the
right.
Those, you know what I mean? They say they type in the three numbers to request the video, like. So it goes back like that, my dude. Like, how do you think the game has changed, like, when it came from, you know, the box to now?
Oh, man, the game then did a 360. What do you mean? You feel me? You know,
I want to say 360 because if you say 360, that means it, the box came right back out. You gotta say like a 180. You know what I mean? Like it just.
Right. You know what I'm talking about? It did a flip flop, man. You know what I'm talking about? Flip flop back like a Arabian gymnast. You know? This shit is twisted.
He said Arabian gymnast.
Yeah, this shit twisted, man, right now. The game is all fucked up. Motherfuckers ain't even rapping. They just rapping the same shit over and over at the same time. You feel me? What makes money. But at the same time, don't disrespect this rap game, man. Don't act like you're a gangster, and you feel me? And put cornrows in your hair and you think it's you the shit when you really ain't. You feel me? It's just something about this rap game is just it's twisted right now. Niggas is wearing tight jeans, super tight, showing their ass and shit. I ain't with none of that shit. You feel me?
You don't sag your skinny jeans?
Man, I ain't never sagged a skinny jean in my motherfucking life. I'm a motherfucking 501 wearer, man. You feel me? Yeah, a true religion or something, man. You know?
Yeah, wearing the kippies.
Hey, man. You passed by me with some skinny jeans. I'm going to talk about you.
Oh, shit. The half skirts ain't flying either, huh?
And you... and you forgot to add too. And you forgot to add too. What these rap dudes doing now is that you know, they actually, you know, buying these strippers and hoes, homes and cars and trying to wipe them up. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's what these motherfuckers been doing though. That ain't nothing new. You feel me? What they do with their money, they do with their what they do with their money, they do with their money, because one of them stripper bitches or hoes might be mine, so I ain't gonna be mad at them. You feel me? If they getting money, you feel me? But the whole point is it ain't gonna be my money flying in the air.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, everybody don't know, like, for those that don't know, like, you always, like, preach that pimp game in your music.
Yeah, that's why.
Basically we had to bring that up to speed. Like when it comes to motherfuckers out here trying to wipe these strippers, and we all know, like, if we all know, like, even if we're not a pimp ourselves, like, if you was brought up with a pimp or listened to pimp rules, that's like against the rules.
if you was raised by pimps and all that, know all the rules, and you're not a pimp, it's against the rules.
No. Like the rules against the rules is like, wifing strippers and, you know, basically on your boo loving shit, like, yo, this is my wife right here, like, even though she done gargled mad nuts from motherfuckers on my team.
Right. I ain't gonna never understand that. That ain't even my book of vocabulary. You feel me? I don't understand that shit. But at the same time, man, they do what they do. You feel me? Somebody always looking for somebody. But at the same time, man, if they doing it, it ain't gonna be me, Bob. You feel me, nigga? I ain't fucking with you, nigga. Pivot and pivot.
So that's why we have to bring that to your attention, because. That ain't no pimp shit.
You
don't stick your pinky ring up for shit like that, man.
Oh, boy.
Hey. I mean,
you know, it's a certain type of motherfuckers. Motherfuckers gotta have this shit embedded in them. It ain't just, you know, niggas that pick it up, they just run off with it and fuck it all up. You feel me? So pimping is different. It's a different term to this shit right now. Niggas ain't even looking like pimps no more. You don't even know who pimping right now. They might look like a straight gangbanger and they got 4, 5, 6 hoes on the track. You feel me?
You're right.
Yeah, this shit ain't real pimping. Because the pimping I know, nigga, you get dressed up, you get ready for the nighttime and go get dressed up, man, up to par. You feel me? And get chose on. You feel me? That's what I know about. But you know, nowadays these niggas getting McDonald's money and think they pimping. Real shit. You know, these niggas pimping for a bottle of Hennessy and a sack of weed. You know what I'm talking about? And $10 in the gas tank.
Gotta make
sure
it's real to it, huh?
Yeah.
spit that shit.
I didn't seen it, man. You feel me? This shit, I ain't blind to the fact. I am not blind.
Yeah. Well, I was gonna ask him, he came out around that time when Mac came out, right? What was like the feeling like when that came out?
Not when the Mac came out, man. You making me damn near 70 years old. The Mac been out way before me. But hey, man, you feel me? It was made in Oakland. I got folks in the Mac. You feel me? I got family in the Mac. You feel me?
Yeah.
But, you know, see, my thing is, you feel me? It's embedded in me. You feel me? My family was pimps. You feel me? Most of my aunties was hoes. You know, shit like that. But, you know, the whole game was just came around to where, you feel me, I made it a little different for myself because I was grinding. I put my dope money into my rap game. You feel me? Got to get out the dope game, put it into the rap game. You feel me? And then the rap game, from the rap game, you feel me, I just was spitting this old piece shit, and then, you feel me, it was automatically pimping. You feel me? And then I got money like that, and you feel me? You know, nigga get older, though, you feel me? But it just don't stop. It's embedded. You feel me? I got a doll right now. I got a doll right now. No.
Okay, turn down the music a little bit. Just turn down the music just a little bit.
Gotcha. Hold on 1 second.
Yeah, the music a little bit too loud, so we don't sound
there
too crazy. Yeah.
Yeah. We sound like some old 85 beatbox or something.
Y'all got that what's that boy name? Willie Mack.
Yeah. Hey. And I had to fit for the show because I had my man. He sent us some beats, and I'm like, look, I need some background music. Dru Down gonna be on there. And he sent me this. I'm like, yeah, this is good for the show here. It's that type of flavor.
Yeah, we can still hear. Just didn't want to sound too crazy. Now he was saying that he wanted to play one of your tracks in the background. That's what we normally do for like our guests. We play like a beat, an instrumental from one of our guests' tracks. It's just that it sounded a little bit too loud, so we had to turn it down a little bit so we could sound good.
Yeah. No doubt, because I'm operating from a different phone, so it kind of sounded like a little crazy. But I'm good now. We good now.
Yeah. Well, shit, man, you know, I'm getting ready for the show in Akron, Ohio, man. You feel me?
That's right.
What's up.
Yeah.
You have some new songs from the new album? Are you doing old songs? How you doing it?
I'm doing old and new.
Huh. That's
what's up. Giving them a show.
Yeah. I'm doing my stuff.
So what do you think influenced your style though, Dru? Like, cause like I was saying before, like, you know, you people out there that don't know, like, you basically you talk about that pimp shit heavy in your music. So what, you know, if it wasn't the Mac, what influenced, you know, your music other than your lifestyle?
I mean, shit, that's all that influenced. It can't be nothing else. You feel me? That influenced me is my lifestyle. You feel me? My family. You feel me? I told you I was raised in this shit. You feel me? All my uncles and shit, Black Panthers, and you know, they ran with the Max, you feel me, on San Pablo Boulevard way back in the day when I was like the only track popping in Oakland. That's where the Max was made. And then I went to
Dru, come a little closer to the phone because you're starting to sound like you're far away. Come a little closer.
You hear me now?
Yeah, it's a little better.
Well, like I was saying, that's what, that's, you know, born in, embedded, man. I'm born in this shit. You feel me? All over, man. My family was all into the game, so I'm into the game. Ain't nothing new.
Because I know you got to have at least like a favorite movie or something like that. Like when you was younger, you like, you know what?
My favorite movie right here, man. I'm just saying, from back in the day, my favorite movie is Once Upon a Time in America.
Ooh. Mm. Okay.
Pre-game, man. You feel me? And if you really, if niggas don't understand that, niggas ain't gonna never have no money if you in a crew. You feel me? Real shit.
Is that that shit with Edward James Olmos?
You said what now?
Is that that movie with Edward James Olmos when he was down with the Mexican gang?
No, man, this is, you got to pull it up if you don't know about this, some real mob shit. When youngsters grow up together to be old and they still getting money, you feel me? And went through a whole bunch of shit, you feel me? And they're still getting money, you feel me? They ain't on no pimp shit. It's just on some together shit, you feel me? As honor and being solid, you know? Just some real shit. And if you don't know about it, everybody that's listening out there in the world, man, go look at Once Upon a Time in America. You might think it's slow for a minute. You'd be like, oh, if you ain't a movie watcher. But sit your ass down and just watch it and listen to what I'm saying.
You know what movie I was thinking about? I was thinking about American Me. Excuse me. That's a movie with Edward James Olmos. That's what I was thinking about.
I know. For sure, for sure. I know for sure. But yeah, man, like I said, man, I'm trying to, you feel me, get it together, you feel me, so I can get to this motherfucking show, you feel me? I appreciate it and everything. You know what I'm talking about? You already know, man.
Yeah, man.
I will hit y'all again.
Yeah, we appreciate you taking time out, you know, before your show to come chop it up with us. That's definitely peace and love, man, like, you know, and, we definitely hope you smash that fucking show. Hopefully, you bring some hoes out on the stage. Godfather from WWF style.
He said Godfather. Automatically.
Right, well, have fun tonight, and hey, we appreciate you for sure, because we know you could have easily said, nah, you had things to do, so we definitely appreciate you taking this time.
Thank you, man. I appreciate y'all, man. You feel me? I will be back, man. Give me a jingle jangle, you know, on the bell. Tip on, man.
What it do, brother? As a matter of fact, I'm coming in the horizon April 16th, Dru. April 16th. We got a battle going on with some young, hungry lions. You know what I'm saying? One of them is from, I don't know if you know about URLs, Smack, URLs, or Battle. Like, we got one of the dudes from URL to battle on our podcast.
Show.
So it's gonna go down April 16th. You know, you could check that shit out, man.
Yeah, just keep me posted. And I'll get at
definitely.
Me. All right, man. I'll holler at y'all.
Yeah, bro. We
Yo,
appreciate it.
Smash that show, B. Do your thing.
For give us some YouTube show, clips.
Huh?
Yeah, give us some YouTube clips if you could.
All good. One more.
All right, brother.
What kind of shit is this?
Yes, indeed.
Bro, shouts go out to Dru Down for taking the time out to build with the children.
Already.
Exactly.
And your boy is so fly with it. He got that pimp lingo for real. That boy is fly with it. Everything was a whole pimp scenario coming out of his mouth. If you know anything about a pimp, that boy used the lingo to the T. But he ain't
exactly.
Fucking family.
Right.
He breathed from it.
And you know how many cats would have been like, they couldn't do it and do it? He still took the time to chop it up with us and gave us that cosign. So we know we're going to bring him back for a future show.
Hey,
yeah.
Yeah, that was so live. That nigga, he damn sure could have said, hey, I got a show tonight. We're going to have to reschedule this type shit. Or, you know what I'm saying? He was on the phone as soon as the show started. You know what I'm saying? He showed some real respect and time consideration and everything. So, big shout out to that boy, Dru Down. For real.
Word. Because we definitely have more questions to ask. Like, this dude is a legend in the And forgive me if I'm wrong. He's from the West Coast, right?
Yeah, he's from Oakland.
Yeah.
So, like, West Coast legend. He's been around for a very long time. As you know, we had a shitload of questions to ask him. So we definitely got to bring him back.
I think he came out in 94. He's been around. And he was working
exactly.
With
us. We got him for round two coming up.
That's what's up. Big shout out to King Eric for making it happen, Cam.
Thank you.
You know how we do, all man. Right. Especially my dude King. Niggas be digging in the crates, man. All right.
Indeed, that's man.
Hey, so and I was finna ask him. I know, I was just going to say, I was finna ask him about his thoughts on the hip-hop, because I know he came out in, like, 94, and I know it's been a big change since he was out. You know, he was working with Tupac, alone. He's out, Yuck Ma, from everybody back then. And that's why I asked him. He still carried the relationships through, and they still doing good, because, you know, without his beef shit, everybody got beef, everybody breaking up, everybody talking shit. And so, shit, it's just cool to see that the true legends can stick around each other and keep making some legendary type shit. Cause without people like that, without music continuing like that, this bullshit is too prevalent now. Shit, we would be hearing some bullshit with no kind of good beats in between, no kind of good music to hold us over, give us any kind of hope. So that's shout out to all the legends that know how to keep business going and let that bullshit slide to the wayside, man.
And shouts go out to these pimps, man. Shouts go out to these pimps, all these OG pimps. You know what I'm saying? We need y'all out here, babe. We need to keep these hoes in check. You know what I mean? Like, these hoes be thinking they better than they originally are. You gotta, you know, we need these OG pimps to start starting these hoes grow, goddammit. I set my pinky up for that right there.
I was going to shoot to him, too. I was going to tell him. And Cat Williams need to break them royalties off. You know that money might care this for you, dude.
For real. Yeah, that was a good look.
But at the end of the day, you know, shouts out to Dru Down. Hopefully we get him on a show in the near future. Now, let's shift gears. Number one, you know, what's up, y'all? Like, what's going on? How was y'all week? Talk to me. What's up?